next candidate is a lifelong Angelino. She was educated in the public school system and graduated from UCLA. Her public service career began in the office of Mayor Tom Bradley, where she helped create LA Best, a nationally recognized after-school program. Later, she worked with the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development during the Clinton administration, securing over a billion in support for those affected by the Northridge earthquake. In 1997, she went to work for DreamWorks, and in 2002, she was elected to the Los Angeles City Council to represent District 2, voting to improve transportation infrastructure and make LA more business-friendly. She is our current city controller. She put out a very important review of the budget of animal services, which I know we're all interested in. Please welcome Los Angeles City Controller, Ms. Wendy Greuel.
Good afternoon. How y'all doing? You started early? Did you start early?
Yeah.
Well, I'm just happy to be here, and it was interesting. Asked outside by Channel 5, they were interviewing each of us as to why do you think it's so important in the issues that you go around the city, and they list the top three. They never usually include animal rights, animal services, the importance of taking care of our animals. And so why are you all here? That's pretty much what they said, briefly. And I said, because we know, all of us, I mean, you can remember, how many of you remember the first animal you got? Okay, right? I was four, okay? We called the dog, I was Tuffy. I came up with it, because when I went into the shelter, he was the one kind of tough and wanting to, you know, jump and really wanted to be adopted. And I think when I said to them the importance of everyone can understand not only having an animal but protecting an animal. Everyone, it's a gut reaction about the importance of treating our animals humanely and the importance of the city of Los Angeles standing up and the mayor recognizing it, that it's a huge issue. Now, you know, whether I was on the city council or now as a city controller, the importance of ensuring that we as a city are operating in an efficient way, that we're providing the kind of resources, that we're providing the kind of services is desperately needed. Some of you in this room I worked with when I represented the Salamanca area, we probably had more animals in that area than most parts of the city in a council district, not only equestrian, but my husband, who was just my boyfriend at the time when I was running for office, walked precincts with me. And he said, I never knew the city of Los Angeles had chickens and geese and horses and every kind of animal you can imagine as we were knocking on doors. And I said, that's what makes Los Angeles great. So as a council member, I worked on chip-a-thons, and as well as making sure we had pet fairs across the city of Los Angeles, making sure that we had our animal cruelty task force, and the importance of that in ensuring as we go forward, it has a very limited budget, that we need to do more in that area to ensure that we're taking care of the issues of animal cruelty. And as mentioned, thank you. I did an audit of animal services, and also a lot of people said to me, well, why are you doing an audit of animal services? Does it matter? Don't you think it matters?
Yeah.
And it matters on a number of levels. One, clearly we've had a lot of different managers over the years and challenges that this department has faced. And a lot of people have just wanted to close their eyes to it and say, oh, it's, you know, what's happening? And council member, now I have to call him the congressman, Tony Cardenas, who has endorsed me, was one of those incredible leaders on the city council in the importance of ensuring we had an effective, not only animal services department, but more importantly, that we had enough resources for those shelters and the new shelter that used to be in my district, on the one on Sherman Way, which is where I had, you know, found my dog at 4 years old, was the new one went into Tony Cardenas' district. But it's important, when I looked at the audit, I said, I want to just talk to you about a couple of things that were in there. One, the management changes, I think, had put the animals at risk and our employees at risk as well. Also found that there were accusations, of course, of the selling of animals, and also about not knowing how many the physical inventory of our animals. That, to me, is criminal in itself, that we have to be able to understand the input as well. So I'm proud that my audit actually brought to light many of the things that we need to change. in the Animal Services Department. And, you know, for me, like all of you, I look forward to a day in Los Angeles that we have a no-kill. And I think that the time has come. And when I want to, many of you in the room, we have worked together. We have worked together on making sure that we get to that goal, as well as ensuring that sometimes you'll give me a hard time, and I appreciate that. I appreciate that. That always wanting to be there and being strong advocates in the city council, whether it was on the issues of spay and neutering, whether it was making sure we had the resources, I stand with you as well. Now, I want to also just mention to you, one of the things that we found in that audit was that we weren't collecting enough money and people weren't getting their animals each year registration. It was in the tune of $1.2 million. Think about what we could do with $1.2 million. Think of the kind of services that we could provide. And a lot of people I spoke to, particularly in the equestrian community, said to me when I represented them, you know, we never get our notice that we're supposed to pay. We just kind of think, well, I think it's been a year or so. For us in the city of Los Angeles, that is not okay, because it not only benefits clearly us having the resources to provide to all the things we want to do together, but it also is about making sure we know where our animals are. When you think about in a fire, and we did this a lot in the equestrian community, because if there's a fire, people need to be able to ensure that we get those animals out. And that is about the microchipping as well. It's ensuring that we have that, and as much as possible, have the identification of our animals. And so I just wanted to be here today to thank those of you that have been strong advocates, those of you that are holding the city accountable, those of you that are going to make sure the next mayor of Los Angeles understands the importance, so that Channel 5 doesn't ask us, why are we here, and is it really important? Because it is. It is important. Many of you volunteer in our shelters. Many of you volunteer in nonprofit organizations that have built upon what the city's foundation is. But we must do more. And I am a strong believer, and as you'll hear me a lot talking about, we can't just accept the status quo. We just can't say it's okay where we are. A lot of people say, well, you can't afford to do more. You can't afford to do all these things. And I said, I'm going to work hard that we can, so that we can afford to do it. Because as a city controller, I have, and I would say, you know, identified a lot of waste and fraud and abuse and things that if we just did things differently, we'd have the money that we could provide. And I have found that sometimes when you do the right thing, it doesn't make you friends, right? Sometimes it doesn't. And I remember recently, and you can tell me when you cut me off, because, you know, we politicians can talk for a while, but I was at Burbank Airport recently going up to Sacramento, and it was 6 o'clock in the morning, and I thought, who are all these people in line at 6 getting on the, you know, going somewhere? And I wasn't quite awake, and he took my driver's license and my boarding pass, and he didn't even look up. He just said, you know, I don't think people like you very much. And I thought, okay. I literally turned around because I thought he was talking to somebody else. And then he said, but I like you. He says, you're doing a great job as controller. You're finding money. You're going to make sure you hold people accountable and you keep what you're doing. And so I'm going to keep fighting for you. I'm going to keep fighting for our animals that don't have a voice. I'm going to keep fighting to make sure that the city of Los Angeles is responsive to your needs. And I'm going to continue to ask you to be by my side when I'm mayor, to challenge us, and yes, to take us on when you need to. And I look forward to your support and know that this organization and what you've done and all the people that have been here today speaks volumes about your power and about your influence and about what you're going to be able to do to make Los Angeles better. Thank you very, very much.